Semua kau rancang akan berlaku. Mungkin nasib tak menyebelahi aku. Entah mengapa engkau yang aku cinta. Mungkin lebih baik kau ku lepas saja. Ini tidak adil, tidak adil baginya. Ini tidak adil, tidak adil bagiku. Ini tidak adil untuk engkau bertanya jika aku mencintaimu juga. Tidak adil, tidak adil baginya.
Assalamualaikum and hello. My name is Aina Ziha and I'll be talking about child homelessness in Malaysia. Poverty and homelessness are intricately intertwined. High cost of living can sometimes be neglected, with individuals or families are unable to make enough money to cover housing, food, childcare, healthcare, and education. In the rising tide of technology, the issues of homeless children in Malaysia are no exception, especially in a rapidly developing community like Kuala Lumpur and Johor Bahru. These children are like white clothes that need to be well patterned. However, various issues can be found on these street children, especially in the newspaper, television, and social media. This group can be seen severely affected, especially in education. They are always being left out from getting any education, and it's become more apparent during MCO. According to Jasni Hassan Ibrahim and Kamaluddin, 2022, the factors that contribute to street children are due to factors among hardcore poor families. They are financially strapped and only focus on providing basic necessities. Due to the hardships of life, these children have been deployed or need to work at a young age to support their daily lives. Based on our survey, most of the respondents think that the hardcore poverty families were the causes that led to homeless children. Moreover, they also do not have identification documentation. They do not have birth certification or other necessary documents. Due to that, it is difficult for them to get benefits or any social services because they are not properly registered as Malaysian citizens. The third factor can be caused by the lack of interest in education. It is due to their parents do not care much about their importance of education in life, since they live in urban poverty. The basic need has become their need to live. With that, they do not view education as a medium that can help to change their future. It was stated by UKM Educator Faculty of Education, Dr. Anwar Ahmad said they should have attended school but were unable to carry out the obligations due to poverty, living in the countryside, besides being born from a homeless family in an urban area. Moreover, the Global Competitiveness Report 2019, which mentions that 5.8% of the approximately 32 million Malaysians population are out of school or have dropped out of the country's education system. Therefore, the government should take actions to curb this issue. We can look at the government's initiatives, which are Sekolah Bimbingan Jalan Kasih. This school has focused on these children who do not have documents. So children, marginalized children, also orphans living under a registered child care center. The objectives of this program is to provide access to formal education in a conducive environment for street and marginalized children. It also wants to reduce the dropout rate of the population in Malaysia. Ministry of Education aims to ensure no children are left behind in the education system. Furthermore, There's also Pusat Pembelajaran Community, Jalan Chowkit by DBKL. It is to create a local community counseling and psychology center with spiritual activities for homeless children. This program has attracted many NGOs to join, which is the NGO team will teach the children for free. Okay, next. The first challenge of the child homelessness issue in Malaysia is tens of thousands of kids in Malaysia have been denied the opportunity to go to school because the only kids who can show that one parent is a Malaysian or those who have birth certificates or identity card as a proof of citizenship are only allowed to attend to government schools. Malaysian children who are not registered because they were born unmarried or in places without access to government facilities frequently are also denied in education. As they become older, the achievement gap between them and other children who attend school grows exponentially, which breeds resentment and creates a cycle of underachievement, poverty, and discrimination. Next, despite the fact that many facilities have programs aimed at addressing this important social problem, many countries, including Malaysia, lack of funding required to provide assistance to all homeless children. Hence, that is why it is hard to solve this issue as it requires a lot of money to handle it. When the government does not have adequate funds, lots of programs cannot be carried out to lessen the issues of children homelessness in Malaysia. When the homeless children have been multiplied by years and the government still does not have adequate funds to provide assistance to all homeless children in Malaysia, the numbers of homeless children may be escalated and the government still cannot control it. Furthermore, due to their lack of qualifications, the homeless children have no way to support themselves financially. So any help they can receive to go back to the school or probably obtain a qualification or obtain housing facilities will be a huge help to them and will enable them to find stability through obtaining meaningful employment. Unfortunately, they are either forced into prostitution or for minimal wages or maybe meet friends with drug addicts. Last but not least, district children suffer violence, and these children, they're already at risk of abuse by individuals who know they are not protected by family or by the law and have no access to justice, such as those who are not registered, do not have an adult who can speak up for them, or do not have enough shelter, are particularly vulnerable. Even in some situations, law enforcement or government personnel target children for robberies, beatings, or other crimes. Not only that, everyday adults, including government employees and public servants, as well as the police, youngsters, and even their own families, hurt a lot of street-connected kids. Additionally, they are denied their rightful access to healthcare and education. They could go to jail merely for attempting to survive if their country's law make loitering or begging illegal. Next, for the recommendations, since the issue still cannot be eradicated, it can be controlled. The first recommendation that can help to control child homelessness issue in Malaysia is by carrying out a program that can help to reduce their difficulties, such as you attend campus Seremban 3. Students who carry out the program named Dana Kembali ke Sekolah collaborated with District Education Office, PPD, My Day teachers from schools around Seremban 3 and the students of UiTM Seremban 3. One of the objectives of the program is to lighten the burden of parents with B40 status who have children who are still in school. The children will receive brand new school uniforms, stationaries and other school necessities. This then can help to achieve the objectives of this program and can also help to control the child homelessness in Malaysia. Other than that, there are some approaches that the responsible parties can implement to make Malaysia a safer, healthier, and greener place for every child. For example, NGOs can advocate and support changes in policy that are child-friendly, run public campaigns to alter public perceptions of child homelessness in Malaysia, and also raise money to aid both children, Malaysian children and children all around the world. In addition, improving the capacity of the government and its partners to provide each child with high quality services is another approach that can be utilized as a recommendation for this issue. Besides that, the government must do its role to encourage the growth of all of these schools in Malaysia and provide them with the freedom to alter their curriculum as necessary to meet their specific needs of the students. Through the existing health system, it can promote counseling and treatment sessions for individuals who need them, as well as immunizations against common diseases. For the time being, the law must be explicit in allowing all Malaysian children to get a basic education, and in which it must be also included with health education. In conclusion, according to UNCRC, street children need particular resources to address their physical and emotional needs, protections, instruction in how to function in society, education and vocational training. Hence, it urged the full implementation of national policies that use a whole of government approach to enhance children's health and welfare. In order to safeguard young kids and lessen the worst effects of the challenges they encounter, integrated child-centered program must be made available immediately. Each child has only one childhood, which goes by far too soon. Not just some of these kids, but all of these kids are the ones who will shape our society. They must be heard, and we must speak up for them when they lack a voice and knowledge of their difficulties. Also, spending money on children's program is not only a moral thing to do, but it will ultimately save money. And we need to act for now, not the following year, or in a few years later. Thank you.